Hey, what's up? I'm Mike. You're on jamplay.com. We're going to work on the song So Far Away off of the 14 Shades of Grey record. This is one of those songs that you kind of learn early on when you're signed to a major label and you know you actually sell a few records, that people start to give you their opinion and tell you what you need to do, and it gets a little bit difficult. And this song came out of one of those situations. You know, we made Dysfunction, we sold a million records and nobody listened to it before they put it out, but after we did and it did well, then everybody had an opinion and wanted to tell us, you know, what to play, how to play, if it was right. So anyways, we finished the 14 Shades of Grey record, or we thought we finished it, and certain people didn't. And you know, look, it's a good thing, but I think what happens is that Record Exec 101, they try to, you know, put their finger on you and squash you and see what pops out. And anyways, this is one of those songs. We had gone back after, you know, we had pretty much completed the record, and this is something that Aaron had on acoustic. And again, you can, if you hear the acoustic track and then you hear what was added on top of it, you can hear how a song kind of, you know, grows and builds from just something played on an acoustic. So that's the opening acoustic part to So Far Away. Now let's learn it. Starts with a E chord, which is the open E. And what stays constant pretty much for the first three chords anyways is the third fret on the first and second string. So C, open G. Pick those again to a G. So let's do those three chords slowly because they stay the same, the picking pattern pretty much. So it's then to a D, to D suspended, then it starts over again. So the whole thing slowly is like this. So that's the intro part, and it's the only time that that picking part occurs is at the beginning of the song. So let's learn how to play the verse. So it starts with the E chord, but you keep these constant again, which is the third fret on the first and second string. Strum. To a C. To a G. To a D. The suspended, you add that for the last time around. So slowly, the whole thing is. And before it goes into the chorus, it goes back to the C. To the D, and that leads you right into the chorus, which is basically the same chords. You switch them around. You start on the G, you go to the D, you go to the E, you go to the C. So it's the same four chords, they're just in a different order. So we'll do the lead in is. So that's how the chorus is played. Let's learn how to play the bridge. So this is a little bit different, a little trickier. So we start off on an E minor chord to a D with an F sharp to a G, back to the D, to a C, to a D, to an E minor, to the same thing with the F sharp again. So that's one rotation, and that repeats another time for the bridge section. So again, we'll play it slowly, starting with E minor. And that leads us back into the chorus the second time around. Like all Staind songs, you note that this song is tuned down a half step and the acoustic is tuned E to E down a half step. The other thing to know about the song is that it's in 6/8 time, which has, you know, a swing kind of feel. So it's like a 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So that kind of gives it that, you know, raise your mug kind of feel to it. So that starts with the acoustic at the top of the song. And the tuning for the song is G sharp, D sharp, G sharp, C sharp, D sharp, G sharp. So what I do is I have the high two strings tuned down to a D and then a G. So. Tune way low. So it starts at the 14th fret. That's the first chord. Go 14 to 15th fret, to 17. So those three chords are. Harmonic of the 12th fret, pick the 14th fret on the second string, and harmonic on the third string on the 12th fret. So the first phrase is like this. The second time around, the first three chords are the same, and the only thing that changes are the harmonics. So you'll go. First harmonic, fifth fret on the first string, to the ninth fret on the third string, to the fifth fret on the third string. So that slowly is. So when you put the two parts together, it should sound like this. And then the turnaround before the chorus is the second chord. Slide it up a whole step. And strum it three times. So that's a turnaround. Let's move on and learn the chords to the chorus. So that's how the chord progression in the chorus goes. We start out at the 10th fret, barring the bottom three strings, and on the 12th fret, on the third string. So it's the first chord. That moves to the 5th fret, to the 7th, to the 3rd. And the strumming pattern goes like this. Last time you hold that chord out and then back into the verse. Let's move on to learn the bridge part. The first chord is the 5th and 4th string open to the 2nd fret on the fifth and fourth string. To 3-2 on the fifth and fourth string. So it's. Fifth fret barred on the fifth, fourth, and third string. Then it goes to the third fret. To the fifth fret. To the seventh. To the ninth. So you move that three strings barred all the way up. So slowly. The whole progression is like this. And that brings you nicely right back into the chorus. Let's move on to learning the octave part in the chorus part and the little guitar part that kind of emulates what the string section's doing in the bridge. Before we move on, I have to tell you that I had to tune the upper two strings back to F sharp and A sharp because it was basically played on a standard guitar. I recorded the baritones and a lot of times I go back and overdub and do solos on a standard tuned guitar just because it's easier than trying to play those, you know, crazy stretches that have to make the octaves work. The alternate tunings are great for getting nice voicing on chords. They're not great for soloing or playing like single line parts because notes aren't where you expect them to be. So it definitely takes a minute. So this first part starts with an octave at the 10th fret on the third string. Slide down to the 7th fret. 9th fret. The 4th fret. The 5th fret. To 9th fret. To 2nd. Slide to 4th. So slowly, the whole thing's like this. And the last time around, you don't slide up to the fourth, you just hang on the second fret. And after the second chorus, that leads into a string section that's in the song, but basically the notes to play it is a real tricky one. You ready for this? It goes like this. And that just repeats. I'll play it slowly for you. It's very simple. Playing on the first string, it's the 8th, 7th fret. 7th on the 2nd string. And you do that 3 times. Fourth time, you move up to the 10th fret. So that is how we emulate the string section on the guitar. So that's how you play So Far Away. I mean, it's a pretty simple song, but I mean, you know, a lot of times things like that, I mean, really get the job done. I mean, you can see, you know, how the same 4 chords are used in the verse and the chorus just by switching a couple of chords around, and you can, you know, again come up with a really nice melody over it. And that's really what counts and really what's important in a song is the melody. You know, and I remember going back and just how difficult it was to kind of finish that record. I remember going out to the NAMM show and you know, talking to management and the label and basically calling John, Johnny, and Aaron and said, you know, come on out. And we went to Los Angeles and we spent a week. We wrote, you know, So Far Away, Aaron Haddon, I wrote Price to Play and How About You. And we spent a week and recorded it and called them in, and then we were able to say the record was done. But it's definitely a very stressful time, you know, getting that record complete. And that's kind of what led to it. But, you know, look, this song came out of it and it was, you know, very happy that it did. So hope you enjoyed it.